In this tutorial, we are going to model a warehouse. Then we will learn how to unwrap any cubic or rectangular shape in Blender. And at the end, we will learn how to texture our warehouse. It's a part of an entire course. I will leave the link for the course in the description. Please hit the like button on the videos that inspire you and click the subscribe button to become a valued member of our community. Visit our website at artstudio313.net and immerse yourself in a world of artistic exploration. Here is a glimpse of what awaits you. Without any further ado, let's dive into the tutorial. I decided to create a small warehouse at this place. For that, hold down shift and left click to move the 3D cursor first. Then press shift A and from the mesh menu, add a cube. Grab the cube and move that in Y axis. Then by selecting everything, move that in Z axis. Let's select the upper beam and move that up just a bit. Now select the cube and scale it down in Z axis. Move it in Z axis down. And we go to wireframe mode, select the back edge and grab that by G and Z to move it upward. Let's scale it in X axis as well. And again, switch to wireframe mode and select the left edge. Move that in X axis. Select the right edges and move that in X axis towards the right side. Again, in wireframe mode, select the top edges and move that in X axis. Now make sure to align that with the long pillar. In edit mode, add two loop cuts. Then, with the edge mode selected, select two top edges and move those down just a bit. In this way, we will make a curvy or bend the top faces of the warehouse. Now it's time to create some new wooden slats. For that, we need to move the 3D cursor first, then shift A and add a cube. Scale the cube down, then scale it in Z axis. Enter edit mode and scale it in X axis again. Let's select the warehouse and the new wooden slats, then press numpad slash to solo those. Rotate the slats or the beam, then scale it in local X axis. Make sure to be in orthographic mode. Look at from the top orthographic and select the wooden slat because I want to add an array modifier. Let's play around with the factors. Set the count to 5. It is a good idea to have a little bit of gap between these wooden slats. So for that, play around with the Y factor. In this way, we will make it more stylized. I want to make a bend in the center of these slats as we did with the warehouse. With the beam selected, add some loop cuts by Ctrl R. Let's select the center loop cut by holding down Alt, then turn on the proportional editing from the top center. Now press G and move that in Z axis downward. As I said before, while you are using proportional editing, play around with the scroll wheel until you get a good result. As you know, whenever the scale values are changed, we need to apply the scale by Ctrl A to make sure that we are not going to get some problem in the future. On top of the array modifier, I want to add a bevel modifier. Play around with the amount and segments. Let's get it in edit mode to align it with our warehouse. Now press number the slash to get everything back. Let's add some beams around the corner of this warehouse. For that, I will take a copy of one of these beams and move that in the front of the warehouse. Scale it in x-axis and make it align with the corner of the warehouse. Now go to wireframe mode and select the right back edge and move that upward. Look at from the top orthographic mode and scale it again. And move a copy of that to the other side of the warehouse. Let's manipulate this beam to make it chunky. Now for the top wooden slats, apply the array modifier. Let's make the slats more believable and more natural by manipulating them individually. First, make them shade smooth. Select it again, enter tab, and in edit mode press A to select everything. Then press P and choose by loose parts. Tab again to go to object mode. Now, if you select each of these slats, you will see that they are separated individually. Let's grab one of these and enter edit mode. Look at the top orthographic and move them in x-axis. Let's add another loop cut at the center of this slat. Then select these vertices at the bottom and move them down slightly. And the reason for adding this loop cut, you already know the answer, is to making it chunky and crooked. Select the top slats and enter edit mode. Now select all the vertices at the back and with the proportional editing is enabled, move them in x-axis. Let's move down the top wooden beam in z-axis. Make it a bit narrow. Good. So we keep continue work on these. I select the center slat and from the front orthographic I move the entire object towards the left and down. So let's continue making these objects chunky and crooked. Thank you. Oh, look at this rope floating on the air. I don't need it anymore, so let's get rid of it. Let's rotate the house to check what is missing and complete the missing parts. Right at this place, we need to add another beam. Let's grab this upper beam and duplicate it, then rotate it 90 degrees in x-axis. Now select the lower house and the new beam and press numpad/ to solder them. Grab the beam and scale it to make it a square shape. Align it with the corner of this house. Good. Duplicate the same beam and move it to the right side. On this face of the wall, I want to add another door. So let's hold down shift and left click to move the 3D cursor first. Then select the door and the lower house and press numpad/ to solo them. Duplicate the door by Shift D and move that down. Now from the right orthographic, make the second door align with the lower house. Press numpad/. Scale the door a bit. Again, let's select the door and the lower house numpad/ to solve them, and from the top make align the door with the house. I want to make a hole at the bottom of my lower house to place my door, so let's add a cube. Grab the cube and in edit mode, resize it down to fit the door frame. Look at from different orthographic angle to align the cube with the door frame. After done, select the lower house and from Add Modifiers tab, add a Boolean modifier. Set the type to difference and with the eyedropper, select the cube as a target. Now apply the Boolean modifier and delete the cube. If I select the lower house to solo it, you can see that we created a hole right at the bottom of this. Let's add a window on the back side with the same method. So select the window and the house. Make them solo. Duplicate the window and rotate it by 90 degrees. Then place it wherever you think it is needed. You can try to have a horizontal window. But in this case, I think the vertical should be good enough. That's about this video, guys, and see you in the next.
If you have any questions or need assistance, please don't hesitate to reach out to me at artstudio.team313@gmail.com.